So now we'll start with question number 7. In our previous video, what we were doing is we were solving the CS2 September 2019 paper in MS Word. We have already done the first 6 questions. We'll be starting with the 7th question over here. Now in the 7th question, you will see in the second part, there is a lot of algebraic typing, mathematical typing, which is required over here. Now, some of this can be easily written with the notations given by the IFOA, but what IFOA has given in its new update over here is that they have, as you can see over here, they have in the for the 7th question, the first part is likely to be included without any modification, because the first part, you can see, it's very simple, doesn't require much of typing. The second part, which requires appropriate modifications, which requires a significant amount of mathematical notations. So what they can do is they can increase the number of marks. They can increase the number of marks over here. Or what they can do is they can change it into a multiple choice questions. You are not required to include, you do not need to include any workings for multiple choice questions. Question part 3 over here can be included without any modifications. So part 3, you can see again, you can type this down without any much of mathematical notations, right? Also, they have in this document, which is recently issued by the IFOA last week, they have in the appendix given changed question number 7 a bit. They have modified the question number 7. So this I will show you all. I will show you all, first of all, the CS2 exam paper of 2019. So this is the CS2A September 2019 paper, which you see over here. Here you see question number 7. The first part to this question is exactly similar to this question, which is they have issued now recently, the modified version of it. So the first part does not require any much of a typing. So they have just simply kept it same. I will show you all how to write this in Word if you have any issues with that. So this was the answer. I don't think you will face much of an issue with this, but still I will show you all the question number 7. So here I'll type my solution to answer so this needs to be changed to Calibri answer 7 part 1. So this part 1 again you can simply write it down like this: y equal to x if x is less than equal to m, right? You can simply type this down. You can also type this down very simply. Also for this part B, I'll show you all the part B. In part B, you will have to be really careful while writing this f underscore. Now this is a capital Y. You can't simply write small y. Marks will be deducted, because this is the variable y which you need to show, and then within the brackets it's obviously small y equal to f capital X again, and then within the bracket y for y less than m. Let me ignore all. Right? So this is how you can do this, and we have probability x greater than m for y equal to m. Right? This is your part B, which you can simply type down. Now the second part, which you see, requires a lot of mathematical typing. The product sign is given by the notations given in the notations. Product again can be written as product A to B, the limits are A to B, colon, then whatever is there within your product, which is fx. Or you can write product over A to B, and then you can write within the bracket similarly as you did for the sigma. So these two options are there. You can type product in the bracket 1 to 10, then colon, and then type everything which is there over here. But this requires a lot of mathematical typing. Although I will just show you all this first thing, just for the sake of if it comes in the exam, just for that sake I will show you all. But there is a very, very little chance of this sort of question appearing in your September 2020. This will come, but as a MCQ. Okay, so I will type this as L is equal to product which runs over 1 to 10, then giving a colon. Again, I will type it down everything within the brackets. You can ignore brackets if you want to. 0.6 multiplied by C. Again, I'm using a star. I'm not using X because we have X variable here. Okay. This and then X underscore I. This everything is to the power 0.4. So everything to the power minus 0.4, or you can use subscript, superscript as well. I will show you all in the next line how to use subscript, superscript. We have exponential, so for that I'll write exp, within the brackets I'll write minus c into x underscore I, again this entirely in the brackets, to the power 0.6. okay, so this was your first equation which I have written. You can keep this within the brackets, first bracket, if you want to. This entirely which I have written over here is this within the brackets which you see, exactly similar. Okay, so you can do this, not an issue at all. Also the various alternatives to this can be, so here you can use the subscript, superscript. I'll show you all how to do that. You can write this as x control equal to I control equal to, and then to the power minus 0.4. You can do this, not an issue at all. Minus 0.4, you can do this. And for this again, how you can do e to the power, then everything within the brackets. Instead of using exponential, you can write this within the brackets. So I'll just copy and paste it to show you all. Both are acceptable, exp and then everything within the brackets, or e to the power, this everything within the brackets, right? So both can be done. Now what they have done is that they have taken the first part entirely in the similar fashion, but the second part they have broken down into two MCQs. So I will show you all in this part. So the first part is very similar. The second part, what they have done here, see, this was the original question. This was the original question which you had estimate C using the method of maximum likelihood. You just have to calculate C and you have to show the entire likelihood. Okay. Now here, but what they have done is that they have split it into two questions, two MCQs, where the first one, which one of the following options represent up to the multiplicative constant the correct likelihood function. So they have just simply given you the likelihood function over here. The likelihood function over here, solved function. You do not have to show any workings. In part 3, again, it's a 3-mark question. You just have to give the option. It can be A, B, C, D. Just you need to type your answer. That is answer A, answer B. That's it, nothing else. Similarly, for part 3, whatever you give over here, on the basis of that, obviously, you will calculate part 3, right? Whatever likelihood you consider over here, on the basis of that, you will calculate the value of C in this question, in this part 3, right? So part 3 is based on part 2. So what they have said it's very important to read this. Candidates do not need to include any workings for MCQs. Okay, you will just have to mention one answer. You can't be just, I think part B and part C are the two possibilities. So I will give answer part B and part D both. I can, in my answer, I will write both. So whatever be the answer, I will get my marks. No, you will get zero. You will just have to mention one and only one answer. No workings, nothing. Partial marks will also be not given even if you show the workings. So even if you think, those candidates who think that, okay, if I do the workings, I will get certain marks out of it. No, you will get no marks if you show the workings. You will get no marks for that. You will get no marks for that. Right? So just one option, A, B, C, D, whatever you consider to be correct. If it's A, then just A, B, then just B. No workings required, no two or more options to be written. Secondly, you must include workings for all numerical questions that are not multiple choice questions. So those which are not multiple choice questions, for that, obviously you will have to mention, you will have to give the numerical parts. Right? Now the correct answer will not score full marks unless the workings are shown. So if you do not show the workings in the non-MCQ questions, you will not get the full marks. You will have to show all the workings, especially go through the examiner's report. You will understand as to what workings they want in each type of questions, right? Then here we have candidates should type their workings and answers in the Word document using the standard keyboard typing. No need to use the equation editor. So do not use the equation editor at all, only the standard keyboard typing, which by which they mean the notations which they have given, only use that. No need of using the equation editor. Part 4 says that candidates must type all their workings and answers in the Word document. Calculations pasted from other applications will not be accepted. So those who are planning to do something in Excel, to do all the calculations in Excel, because Excel obviously can do all the calculations in Excel very easily. If you do think that you can do that for runoff, maybe for runoff questions or any those questions which you can easily work out in Excel, if you think that you can do it in Excel and copy paste it in Word, no, you will not get your marks. So calculation has to be shown in Word document, otherwise you will not get your marks. And if you think that it will become really difficult, believe me, IFOA makes it really, really simple for you all to type everything down in Word. You just have to practice a little and you'll be done. You don't have to practice a lot. Just simple things as to how to use different notations, how to do these questions in Word, how to just do 5-6 papers in Word and you'll be done. It's more than enough. You do not have to, and also you do not have to show extra calculations. You just have to show the minimum calculations which they want to see. And you can know this if you go through just two, three examiner's report. We are solving one, we'll be solving more examiner's reports, so not an issue at all. Okay, so the first part, as you can see, is exactly in the similar fashion what I have written in my Word over here. Exactly in the similar fashion. See, they have given a lot of spaces in between. So you can give a lot of spaces in between. Also, this is what I showed you all, FY. This is what I showed you all here. See, exactly same thing they have done. This is what I showed for the first, very first likelihood, very first expression, the product expression. After this, you had certain probability factor also. So you can just simply give a multiplication and write that probability factor as well. I'm not doing that, but because that's simple, you can manage that. But now what they have done, they have divided it into two parts, two MCQs basically. First MCQ, the answer is D. Solved answer is D. You do not have to show the workings. The candidates are not required to show any workings. Again and again, why I am highlighting this is because it will take up a lot of your time and you will get no marks out of it. Because what examiners will do is they will simply ignore all the workings which you show. They will not even check the workings. They will just see your answer. So in Word, what you have to do here, just simply part 2, the answer, you can type it down in bold. The answer here is D. That's it. Nothing else you have to write. That's it. If you give any extra workings, zero. You will basically, they will not consider, you will not get zero, but they will not consider, they will just ignore all your workings. If you suppose give, if you say this and then maybe you give a comma, you write B, zero. Just give one correct option, write it in bolds, give this. This is the exact manner you have to show your answer. That's it. Give the question part. You have already written answer 7 over here. Give it in bold, part 2. Answer, give it in bold, part D is your correct option, correct answer. On the basis of the second part, you calculate your third part. So on the basis of this, you calculate your third part. But suppose your second part is wrong. Maybe you have given an answer as A, given an answer as B. So obviously your part 3 also will be wrong, but they will consider it to be correct. So in view of calculations set out below, candidates answering consistently with the following table will be awarded in full. So what they are saying is that even if you answer here, maybe if your even if your answer here was A, part A, but on the basis of part A, the calculation you have done for part 3 is correct, then you will get your full marks. For part 3 only, not for part 2 obviously. Suppose for part 1, part 2 you gave option A as your correct answer, you will get 0 for that. It was of 3 marks, this was of 3 marks, as you can see this was of 3 marks, you will get a 0 here. But in part 2, if you have mentioned part D over here, after A, you will get entirely your 4 marks, you will get your full marks. If you have mentioned part B over here, if you have mentioned answer B over here, you will get 0 in part 2. And if you have mentioned A over here, you will get your 4 marks. So this is the table which they have given, that if you have written part A, B, C, these are the corresponding correct answers for part 3, which they will consider to be, they will consider part 2 to be correct, then they are marking for part 3. But for part 2, obviously they will give you a 0 if your answer is A, B, C. And but if this is the corresponding answer to part 3, they will give you a full 4 marks. This was your first thing. Now the second thing, if you mention C in your second part, obviously you'll get a 0. But that in corresponding to part 3, you mention some other answer. Maybe you mention C. Then what? So candidates providing Let me take this. Candidates incorrectly answering A, B, C in part 2 and correctly answering part C to part 3 question will be awarded half a marks. So what this means is that if you answer A, B or C for part 2, which is correct, which is wrong, you will get a 0. So agar aap part 2 mein A, B or C mention kar rahe ho, uska obviously aapko 3 mein se 0 milega. Because वो wrong है. But अगर आप part 3 में correct answer C mention कर रहे हो, so they will not give you full marks, but they will give you half a mark, which is 2. तो आपको part 3 के लिए 2 marks मिलेगा. यहाँ पे आपको 0 मिलेगा obviously, because आपने गलत किया है. यहाँ आपने सही किया है, part C किया है, but आपना आपका part 2 गलत था, and on the basis of part 2 only we can calculate part 3. Part 3 अलग से हम नहीं calculate कर सकते without skipping part 2. तो इसका आपको half marks मिलेगा, which is only 2 marks. आपको पूरा marks नहीं मिलेगा, which is what they have mentioned over here. For such candidates, it would not be known whether the answer to part 3 had been derived by a valid method independent of part 2 or whether further error had been made in following through. Such candidates' workings receive no credit. Multiple choice questions, any workings offered in documents will be strictly ignored. जो मैंने बोला multiple choice questions में अगर आप कोई भी workings दिखाते हो तो आपको 0 मिलेगा. ये 4 marks का question है. You just have to give the correct answer. जो भी workings है you will do it within pen and paper. Word में दिखाओगे वो ignore होगा, उसमें आपको कोई marks नहीं मिलेगा. अगेन वन मोर पॉसिबिलिटी कैन बी देयर कि आप पार्ट टू में आप कोई आंसर नहीं देते हो, आप कुछ नहीं लिखते हो. सपोज आपको पता नहीं है पार्ट टू, आप अनश्योर हो, आपने कुछ नहीं लिखा उसमें. बट पार्ट थ्री में आपने पार्ट सी आंसर सही लिखा. सो यू हैव गिवन नो आंसर फॉर पार्ट टू बट यू हैव करेक्टली आंसर्ड पार्ट थ्री, तो आपको इसमें फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा बिकॉज दे मे कंसिडर. ऐसा हो सकता है कि आपने कोई ऐसा अप्रोच लगाया हो जिससे आपका पार्ट थ्री निकल गया बट आप पार्ट टू में अनश्योर हो. सो तीन चीज़ हैं विच आई एम रिपीटिंग इट अगेन. अगर पार्ट टू एंड थ्री आप सही आंसर करते हो तो ऑब्वियसली थ्री एंड फोर मार्क्स पूरा मिलेगा. अगर आप गलत आंसर करते हो, पार्ट टू ए बी सी लिखते हो विच इज़ रॉन्ग, तो आपको पार्ट टू में तो जीरो मार्क्स मिलेगा. पर पार्ट थ्री में अगर कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंगली आप उसका सही लिखते हो, जैसे ए का पार्ट डी सही है, बी लिखोगे तो पार्ट ए सही है, अगर आप ये करते हो तो आपको पार्ट टू में तो ऑब्वियसली जीरो मिलेगा बट पार्ट थ्री में आपको पूरा फोर मार्क्स मिलेगा. दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट पॉसिबिलिटी कि आपको फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा इस वाले पार्ट में. पार्ट टू में तो आपको जीरो मिल रहा है बट पार्ट थ्री में आपको फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा. सेकेंड पॉसिबिलिटी है कि अगर आप यहाँ पे आंसर ही नहीं मेंशन करो, अगर आप पार्ट टू में कोई आंसर नहीं लिखोगे तो ऑब्वियसली जीरो मिलेगा, बट पार्ट थ्री में अगर आप सही लिखोगे, आप सी लिखोगे, आंसर सी लिखोगे विच इज़ करेक्ट, यू विल गेट इंटायरली फोर मार्क्स. दिस इज़ योर सेकेंड पॉसिबिलिटी कि पार्ट टू में आपने कुछ नहीं लिखा, आपको जीरो मिला, बट पार्ट थ्री में आपने सी लिखा है, आपको फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा विच इज़ फोर मार्क्स. थर्ड पॉसिबिलिटी है कि आपने सेकेंड पार्ट में कुछ गलत लिखा है, ए बी सी लिखा है विच इज़ रॉन्ग, ऑब्वियसली आपको उसमें जीरो मिलेगा, बट पार्ट थ्री में आपने सही लिखा है विच इज़ पार्ट सी. आपने पार्ट टू में ए बी या सी लिखा है विच इज़ रॉन्ग, उसके लिए जीरो मिल गया, बट पार्ट थ्री में आपने सी लिखा है विच इज़ करेक्ट, तो उसमें आपको हाफ मार्क्स मिलेगा, यानी कि फोर नहीं मिलके टू मिलेगा. सो दीज आर द वेरियस कॉम्बिनेशंस विच दे हैव स्टेटेड. क्योंकि दोनों क्वेश्चंस इंटर रिलेटेड है, थ्री इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन टू, तो अगर आप टू में कुछ गड़बड़ करते हो दे विल कंसिडर इट टू बी करेक्ट एंड दे विल टेक इट डाउन फॉर थ्री. बट अगर आप कुछ ऐसा गड़बड़ करके पार्ट थ्री में अलग ही अपना आंसर लिख देते हो जो कि वो भी सही नहीं है, तो उसमें आपको हाफ मार्क्स मिलेगा. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट पॉसिबिलिटीज विच दे हैव कंसिडर्ड ओवर हियर विच दे हैव टेकन फॉर द एमसीक्यू टाइप क्वेश्चंस. अगेन आई हैव हाईलाइटेड दीज की लाइंस ओवर हियर. वर्किंग्स करोगे दे विल सिंपली इग्नोर इट, कुछ देखेंगे नहीं, टाइम भी आपका वेस्ट होगा, तो वर्किंग्स करना ही नहीं है. सिंपली आंसर ऐसे लिखना है जैसे मैंने इधर वर्ड में लिख के दिखाया, ऐसे आंसर इक्वल टू डी, कीप इट इन बोल्ड सो दैट इट स्टैंड आउट. एंड मैंने यहाँ पे तीन पॉसिबिलिटीज़ भी आपको बता दिए कि अगर पार्ट टू एंड थ्री आर डिपेंडेंट क्वेश्चंस, सो व्हाट आर द थ्री डिफरेंट पॉसिबिलिटीज विच माइट अराइज इन सच केसेस, आपको कैसे कैसे मार्क्स मिलेंगे. दोनों पार्ट सही है तो फुल मार्क्स, पहला पार्ट सही है दूसरा पार्ट गलत है तो पहले पार्ट के लिए फुल मार्क्स, दूसरा पार्ट पूरा जीरो मिलेगा. पहला पार्ट गलत है पर उसके बेसिस पे आपने सेकेंड थर्ड पार्ट सही किया है, तो उसके लिए आपको पहले पार्ट में तो ऑब्वियसली गलत मिल रहा है और दूसरे पार्ट में आपको फुल मार्क्स मिलेगा. वापस मैं रिपीट करूँ, अगर आपका पहला पार्ट में आपने कुछ गलत लिखा है एंड यहाँ पे कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंगली आपने पार्ट सी लिख दिया है, तो उसका आपको हाफ अ मार्क्स मिलेगा. और दूसरा चीज़, अगर आपने पहले पार्ट में पार्ट टू में आपने कुछ भी आंसर नहीं लिखा ब्लैंक छोड़ दिया है एंड पार्ट थ्री में आपने पार्ट सी लिखा विच इज़ करेक्ट, you will get your full marks. So they, see these are the three possibilities. I don't think any other possibility ho sakta hai aise do MCQ questions mein. So this is what they have done. Again, seven questions ka hi part 3 dekhenge agar hum yahan pe. Dekho yahan pe inhone solve kiya hai pura. Ki if you have written answer A to part 2, to uska answer kya hona chahiye? Answer B hona chahiye. Dekho yahan pe table mein, theek hai? Agar aapne part A kiya hai तो उसका सोल्यूशन क्या होगा, अगर आपने पार्ट बी किया तो उसका सोल्यूशन क्या होगा, पार्ट डी किया होगा तो उसका सोल्यूशन क्या होगा. पार्ट फोर अगेन एकदम सेम है, कुछ चेंज नहीं किया है उन्होंने, सिमिलरली लिया है. मैं दिखा देती हूँ इसको वर्ड में कैसे टाइप करेंगे, विच इज़ अगेन वेरी सिंपल, कोई दिक्कत नहीं होगा आपको पार्ट फोर को सॉल्व करने में. मैं दिखा देती हूँ कैसे पार्ट फोर भी हम लोग का सॉल्व होगा इधर. सो दिस इज़ पार्ट फोर विच आई विल शो यू ऑल, नॉट एन इशू, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, सब कुछ सेम है. ठीक है, सो यहाँ पे यू विल जस्ट सिंपली राइट मीडियन इज 700. आई विल जस्ट शो यू ऑल द सेकेंड लाइन, अगर आपको कोई भी कन्फ्यूजन है, एम दिस इज इक्वल टू वन minus exp and then within the brackets you write minus cm to the power 0.6. So this is nothing but which you see in your solution in your examiner's report over here. In your examiner's report, dekho. Yahan pe ye aise hai. So this is corresponding to this. Fm equal to 1 minus exp. जो मैंने ई एक्सपी लिखा या फिर आप ऐसे भी लिख सकते हो ई टू दी पार करके भी लिख सकते हो इट्स द सेम थिंग राइट मैं जस्ट जल्दी से दिखा देती हूँ बिकॉज इट्स रियली सिंपल इट विल नॉट टेक मच ऑफ द टाइम 700 टू दी पार 0.6 विच इज इक्वल टू अगेन एल एन ब्रैकेट में हम लिख देते हैं 0.5 विच इज सी आपका इक्वल टू सो इट्स सी इक्वल टू 0.01361. This is what they have shown in their PDF which they have released recently. ठीक है तो यहाँ पे आपको इसका full 4 marks मिलेगा because यहाँ पे आपका कोई ऐसा as such notation नहीं है simple से notations हैं. Part 3 was where you used a lot of notations जिसको उन्होंने MCQ में तोड़ दिया है दो MCQ में तोड़ दिया है एंड मैंने सारे possibilities आपको बता दिए कि क्या क्या पॉसिबिलिटीज हो सकते हैं ओके इन आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 थैंक यू